channel. So I just wanted to talk to you today about two IPO trades I took and how I traded them and how I scaled in and out depending on volume and different breakouts or patterns that I saw. So first I had RIVN here, which was a very hyped IPO in electric business, electric company field, such as Tesla. We have another one that's very hot. So what I did is I just traded the open, so around 105 I bought and then exited around the 114 for a great gain on the first day. Then what I did is I waited for the next day. I didn't enter any trades on it because I just wasn't very positive about it. I wasn't exactly sure, so I thought to wait for a breakout over, let's say, the pre-market high on the next day, right? So this stock was hot, so it had like these levels here. So what I ended up doing is I bought the breakout here and then exited right before open. So that was a great gain for me, about 4 points. And then I just sat back and I waited for something to form or something to show me a little bit of strength. And then what I saw is this breakout here, so I ended up buying into the strength here. And then obviously the stock rallied about 8 points, where I thought, you know, I had to take about a good portion of my position, almost half the amount here, and then I exited. I took out some more over here before this dump. So the dump wasn't as much, so I ended up adding and then getting some out. But then the strength showed me that later in the aftermarket, it showed me that I should swing this, so I did. And then the next day, I ended up getting, you know, some shares out right in the morning, my last piece. And then I made some other trades on it, but it's important to look for patterns and breakouts, you know, and then where the volume comes in, because later I ended up, a week later, I ended up taking a trade around these levels, 105 for a few points as well. I took that trade on my interactive. At the same time, the market was going up, so of course, RIVN would go up. The other one I took trades on was SEV, which is also a another EV company. So what I did is I didn't play the morning, I mean the open, but I waited for the volume to come in. So as soon as I saw a big amount of volume, I ended up entering this trade. Then there was some weakness, but it held these levels, so I waited for a pop. So through this wedge here, it came out, and then I ended up exiting for about 8 points of gain. I took half of my position, and then I waited to see how it would go from there so I can swing the rest for the next day. So what I did is I ended up holding this overnight, and then I woke up kind of late, so I didn't exit at this. This was about 4 a.m. where it hit $53. So I ended up holding this through, and I waited for a little pop to exit. There was no pop, so I kept holding. And then right before the market opened, I exited another half of my position, and then it just tanked to a huge, much lower point. So that's where I exited another 5 shares, but I traded this correctly. So it was about a 20 point gain. And then this one was about another 30 point gain from the bottoms. So those are some great trades. That's how I trade most IPOs that are hyped. So if you found some value in this video, hit the thumbs up. And let me know if you have any questions below. At all times, obviously, keep your eye on the market and set your alerts for in case you're using other stocks that you're trading. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions, if you need anything, and I'm here.